Hi, I'm Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to do a quick static check on Yaskawa's CIMR-PC3 series of inverters. Now, unfortunately, for most of this series, half of the DC bus isn't accessible, so we won't be able to perform a full static check like we could on other similar inverters, but some check is better than no check, at least that's in my book. So after the drive has been powered off and sitting for some time, the DC bus should discharge, and there's a charge light here that should no longer be illuminated once the DC bus has been discharged. So once we've verified that, we'll go ahead and put our digital multimeter on the diode check function, and then we're going to be checking the inputs and outputs of the transistor module. Let's go ahead and put the negative side of the digital multimeter on the B1 connection here, and then we're going to take the positive side of our digital multimeter and go between L1, L2, and L3. And what we're really looking for is that they're all balanced in between 0.2 and 1, which they are, so that's great. And so let's go ahead and check between UV and W, 0.43, 0.43, 0.43, exactly. Now half the transistor module checks good. There still could be a problem with the other half that we can't see with this static check, but we're just going to go ahead and press on with the rest of our tests. So the next check that we're going to perform is a phase to ground check, and we're going to go ahead and place our digital multimeter in the resistance function and check each phase to make sure that it's not grounded. I'm going to use this as a ground here, and we should verify that it is a good ground, and it is. And then we'll go just between each terminal and verify that none of the phases have accidentally become grounded, which they haven't. So these checks that we perform are just part of a full evaluation that we can provide here at Precision Zone. Even if everything that you've checked today still checks good, there may be a problem within the drive, but obviously if something fails, then it's an immediate action that your drive is going to need to be sent in for repair. Now, if you need any more help doing this or any more help troubleshooting your drive, please contact us at Precision Zone. We would be more than happy to help you. Thanks for watching.